I set out from the north gates of the city. I had sailed there when I heard the news. I chose to walk, to see the lands, to feel the vast spread of the Karanas, and even after so much time had passed, it still felt both familiar and new. I followed the same path that spawned so many adventures and saw so many travellers over the years.
Maybe in another life I could find you there. Pulled away before your time, I can't deal. It's so unfair, and it feels like heaven so far away. And it feels like the world has grown cold now that you've gone away. Leaving flowers on your grave show that I still care. Black roses and Hail Marys can't bring back what's taken from me. I reach to the sky and call out your name. And if I could trade, I would. And it feels like heaven so far away. And it stings now. The world has grown cold now that you've got away. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, oh. Yeah, I'll save your soul. Oh, yeah. I reach to the sky and call out your name. Oh, please let me trade. I would. And it feels like heaven so far away. And it feels like the world has grown cold now that you've gone away. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Spires still stood, and the bridges were in good repair and guarded still. Kanos may be a backwater now, but its power is not completely spent. Across the bridge and into the eastern range of Karana I went, into a small settlement where I found what I sought. But Marcus sat there, just as I'd been told, his flaming sword now permanently sheathed in the rock that marks his passing. And I sat a while and thought of all his works and deeds and adventures we had shared in realms now forgotten.
Perhaps I wept a bit,
lost in thought there in a quiet corner of Norath. Time passed and day turned into night and back into day as I sat. There are so many memories and his labours were great, but now he is at rest, and he'll forever be part of his creation, the land he tore to bring to life for so many.